Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Wednesday of the 13th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. All people, clap your hands. Cry to God with shouts of joy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Magandang araw ho mga kapamilya. July na ho, July 1, so panibagong buwan. At panalangin natin na isang maging magandang buwan para sa lahat, lalo-lalo na para sa ating, para sa bayan at sa simbahan. Panalangin natin ngayong July. Ngayon July, kapistahan ni St. Ignatius of Loyola. So this is July. So I always make July the Ignatian month. So we will refer to him from time to time during our masses. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Seek good and not evil, that you may live. Then truly will the Lord, the God of hosts, be with you as you claim. Hate evil and love good, and let justice prevail at the gate. Then it may be that the Lord, the God of hosts, will have pity on the remnant of Joseph. I spurn your feasts, says the Lord. I take no pleasure in your solemnities. Your cereal offerings I will not accept, nor consider your stall-fed peace offerings. Away with your noisy songs. I will not listen to the melodies of your harps. But if you would offer me burnt offerings, then let justice surge like water, and goodness like an unfailing stream. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, to the upright I will show you the saving power of God.
To the upright I will show you the saving power of God.
Hear my people, and I will speak Israel. I will testify against you. God, your God, am I.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
For mine are all the animals of the forest, beasts by the thousands on my mountains. I know all the birds of the air, and whatever stirs in the plains belong to me.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
If I were hungry, I should not tell you, for mine are the world and its fullness. Do I eat the flesh of strong bulls, or is the blood of goats my drink?
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth, though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you?
To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Alleluia, alleluia. The Father willed to give us birth by the word of truth, that we may be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus came to the territory of the Gadarenes, two demoniacs who were coming from the tombs met him. They were so savage that no one could travel by that road. They cried out, "What have you to do with us, Son of God? Have you come here to torment us before the appointed time?" Some distance away, a herd of many swine was feeding. The demons pleaded with him, If you drive us out, send us into the herd of swine. And he said to them, Go then, they came out and entered the swine, and the whole herd rushed down the steep bank into the sea, where they drowned. The swine herds ran away, and when they came to the town, they reported everything, including what had happened to the demoniacs. Thereupon the whole town came out to meet Jesus, and when they saw him, they begged him to leave their district. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Itong ebanghelyo natin ngayong araw, kung tutusin nyo, dun sa ating pag-celebrate ng Misa, katatapos lang natin nung nakaraang linggo, di ba, yung Sermon on the Mount, di ba? So ngayon naman, pumapasok tayo dahil itong nakaraang Lunes at Martes, parang medyo iba yung mga Gospels. Ano? Pero ngayon, pumapasok tayo sa mga ilang pangyayari sa ministry ng Panginoon. No? So we look at very specific instances of Christ's ministry. Today you have the driving out of the demoniacs. And then tomorrow, Thursday, you will have our gospel for tomorrow will be the curing of the paralytic. No? And then Friday, which is First Friday naman, is the Feast of St. Thomas. But anyway, for today, itong exorcism, kumbaga, no? Meron lang ilang tema na siguro pwede natin pagnilayan. Itong kwentong to, nagpapakita na merong kasamaan sa mundo, no? That there is the presence of evil in the world. And this was something na pinaniniwalaan ng mga tao noon. At ngayon, marami kong naririnig, di ba, magbuhat itong pandemic, yung maraming gulong nangyayari. A lot of people are saying that there is so much evil in the world that we need to pray, we need to counter evil with good. And I think totoo yun, ano? Talagang meron namang kasamaan sa mundo. At kahit ang simbahan, di ba, kanyang tinatanggap niya na merong evil spirit, merong demonic possessions. But basically, I think, let me go back dun sa isang tema na nabanggit ko noong matagal na, yung remember after Jesus proclaimed in the Gospel of Luke, he proclaimed that he was the fulfillment of the coming of the Messiah. Ang very first act na ginawa niya after saying that the ministry begins was he exorcised a demon. And that was very symbolic that the basic battle is between good and evil. And I think that is the basic message also of the Lord, that he came to overcome evil with good. He came to overcome sin and death with the sacrifice on the cross. Let us not forget that, no? That there is a basic battle between good and evil in the world. And therefore, kailangan natin gumawa ng mabuti, kailangan natin magdasal na magabayan tayo, at malabanan natin ang kasamaan, ano? So yun yung first point, di ba? That battle between good and evil, no? And then the second point is that kung mapapansin ninyo, nakilala ang Panginoon noong evil spirit, no? At natakot sila, no? At alam nila na merong plano ang Diyos, ano? And I guess it's very important for us to realize that, you know, that the Lord really is our greatest assurance that we will overcome evil, that by ourselves, di ba, siguro kaya natin, yung kabaitan natin, lahat. But at the end of it all, remember, Christ is, and the cross of Christ is what won us that victory over evil, over sin and death and evil. That is, na ano nga, sabi nga ng mga ibang theologians, you know, it is a victory once and for all. And one Jesuit theologian would say, di ba, with the sacrifice on the cross, di ba, our sins are forgiven, the past, the present, and the future sins, no? Provided that we embrace the cross and we live our lives according to that, no? That in the end, our guarantee of salvation, of doing good, is again, yung krus at muling pagkabuhay ng Panginoon, yung Paschal Mystery. Balik tayo dun sa Paschal Mystery. And yung third and last point na nais kong pagnilaya natin dito sa Ebanghelyo to, pansinin ninyo yung tapos ng Ebanghelyo. Kung saan, nung nabalitaan ng mga tao sa bayan na yun ngang mga masasamang espiritu, and remember, kinatatakutan to ng buong bayan, walang dumadaan, walang nagpupunta sa lugar na yun, ano? Tapos nabalitaan nila na pinapunta ng Panginoon dun sa mga baboy at nalunod, what did the gospel say? They went out from the town, umalis, kasi nagsumbong yung mga parang swine herds, ano? Yung mga swine herds, nagsumbong sila. Whereupon, the whole town came out to meet Jesus. Sinalubong nila si Jesus. Ayaw nilang papasukin ng bayan nila. Alam mo, parang ano yan eh, para yan na pag ayaw nating manindigan para sa katotohanan, pag ayaw nating manindigan kung ano yung mabuti, di ba meron din ganung bahagi ng pagkatao natin, di ba, na pagka hinihingi na tayo ay manindigan para sa kabutihan at para sa Panginoon, natatakot tayo, di ba? Wag na lang kasi tahimik ang buhay ko, wag mo na kaming guluhin. No, but I think part of the Christian challenge is to take a stand, no? In this battle between good and evil, we need to take a stand. Because remember that there is also such a thing as the sin of omission. Na pagka wala tayong ginawa, ay tumutulong tayo na mapalaganap ang kasamaan, di ba? So kailangan din manindigan tayo. Bahagi 'yon ng ating pananampalataya. Kaya hilingin natin ngayon na sana ay sa ating paglalakbay nitong buwan ng Hulyo, this month of July, we may be able to really further deepen our commitment to Christ, our following of Christ as Ignatius, as one of the themes he will develop this month, that we will deepen that and that our following of Christ will bear fruit in the way we will live our life, in what we will commit ourselves to in our day-to-day life. Panalangin natin to na tayo'y higit na makasunod sa ating Panginoon sa ating araw-araw na buhay. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And together now, let us offer our prayers and petitions. And again, we continue to pray for all the frontliners, especially those in the hospitals, in the medical profession, that the Lord may give them protection. We pray also for those who are back to work, that the Lord may also give them protection, especially those who belong to the transport industry, and also for the utilities. And we pray especially also for media people. And let's also pray for all those who are sick, those who have been afflicted by the virus. And let us pray too for their families, for strength and hope. And let's also pray for the families who are suffering because many of them are not still able to go back to work. Let us pray that the Lord may grant them consolation, but also that the government and the private sector may work together to bring help to these families who are suffering, and that soon, hopefully, they may have some source of income. And let's pray also for all those who had passed away because of this pandemic. And let's continue to pray again. We request your prayers for ABS as the hearings continue. Let us pray that the Lord may grant ABS the franchise, and we ask you to pray together with us.
Loving Father, our risen Lord and most Holy Spirit, you guide all the affairs of men and women of goodwill. We thank you for the gift of mission to ABS-CBN to be in the service of the Filipino. We thank you for blessing ABS-CBN's work, most especially with the millions of Filipinos and friends who are one with ABS-CBN in its mission. We in ABS-CBN pray that with grateful hearts we will strive to be better, continuing to improve on the service we render and correcting our failures and shortcomings. We turn to you now, one in prayer, faith, and hope, in ABS-CBN's need, humbly asking that you send your Spirit to guide all our leaders in the executive and judicial branches of government, and most especially our congressmen and women and our senators, that they may conduct a fair and truthful hearing and come to a decision that is for the greater good of the greater majority of the Filipino people and of our world, and what is for your greater glory. We ask this through the intercession of Our Lady of Fatima, and in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Your goodness, we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual food.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love, we celebrate His death. With living faith, we proclaim His resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await His return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Together, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Amen. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.